is part of doing that.
And quickly, can I circle back, to use that phrase, to a question I asked during the transition?
Anyone can steal it. Just means you have to get back.
So I'll circle back to this. Has the White House made a determination about whether it will continue to extend the privilege of intelligence briefings to former President Trump, given the concerns among some Democrats that he'll either misuse it or leverage it to enrich himself?
Mm-hmm. This is a good question. I've raised it with our intelligence teams, or our national security team, I should say. It's something, obviously, that's under review, but there was not a conclusion last I asked them about it, but I'm happy to follow up on it and see if there's more to share. Go ahead in the back.
As you know, President Trump has been barred from a lot of social media sites. Just curious whether you think his absence has made your job any easier, or the White House's job any easier, as it kind of goes forward on these COVID negotiations.
In what way?
He created a lot of noise, right? He would have a certain gravitational pull with Republicans who may be more inclined to take a harder position. Wonder if that's been anything that you guys have thought about or kind of considered.
This may be hard to believe. We don't spend a lot of time talking about or thinking about President Trump here, former President Trump, to be very clear. I think that's a question that's probably more appropriate for Republican members who are looking for ways to support a bipartisan package and whether that gives them space. But I can't say we miss him on Twitter.
Does President Biden support the continuing ban of President Trump on their sites?
I think that's a decision made by Twitter. We've certainly spoken to, and he's spoken to, the need for social media platforms to continue to take steps to reduce hate speech. But we don't have more for you on it than that.